Hi everyone. Today we will work on how to restore and update the U-boot image in the NAND flash on the OMAP-L138 LCDK EVM. There are times that the U-boot image in the NAND may be corrupted or the U-boot needs to be updated to a different or fixed version. This video will show you how to perform the U-boot image update by flashing the NAND using three different methods. The NAND can be flashed in UART2 mode through USB-UART port or using NANDWRITE command from U-boot prompt. It can even be done from Linux kernel. However, this requires the user space utility, which will be shown later in the video. We'll go through each of these three methods in this video. In the case where the content in NAND is totally corrupted for some reason, the only way to recover is to restore the U-boot to the manufacturer's default. This restore is done by flashing the U-boot binary into the NAND through the USB UART connection using the Windows-based serial boot and the flash loading utility for OMAP-L138. This Windows utility can be downloaded from the TI processor wiki at the link shown in this URL. The unzipped package includes the serial flashing utility executable, U-boot binary image, and a README file. The LCDK needs to connect to the Windows PC through the USB UART connection, so the DIP switch SW1 needs to set to UART2 mode, that is pin 1 to 4 be off, on, off, on, as shown. The teratome setting should be 115200 baud rate and 8N1. To verify the setting, the teratome screen should display boot me after the reset button is pressed. Once verified, the teratome needs to be closed while flashing the NAND. On the PC, start the command.exe screen and the CD to the flashing utility folder. First, erase the NAND with the erase command as shown. When it prompts for waiting for boot me, press the reset button on the OMAP-L138 LCDK. The PC screen will show the erase is completed. Then issue the flash command to burn the image. Once flashing is completed, set the disk switch SW1 back to NAND 16 mode, which is pin 1 to 4 as off, on, on, on. If the U-boot image restoration is successful, the UART console will show the U-boot prompt once the LCDK is powered up. If the .ais file is replaced with a newer version, then the U-boot in NAND will be updated with this newer version. For more detailed information, please refer to the readme.txt file in the flashing utility folder. Now, let's look at another way of updating the U-boot image in NAND. If the OMAP-L138 LCDK is powered up and you can get to the U-boot prompt, then the image can be updated from the U-boot console. Please note that there is an issue with the NAND ECC layout on OMAP-L138 and other devices. The ECC layout maintained by NAND driver of U-boot and the Linux does not comply with ECC layout maintained by the RBL or UBL. The 64 bytes of ECC layout for RBL UBL shown on the left diagram has 6 bytes of out-of-band free and 10 bytes of ECC alternatively. The ECC is marked green in this diagram. However, for the U-boot and the Linux, the ECC layout shown on the right diagram has the first 24 bytes of other data and 40 bytes of ECC followed. Some of the devices have U-boot code patched to match the ECC layout as the RBL or UBL. To verify if the patch has been applied, you can check in U-boot drivers MTD nand/davinci-nand.c file to see if the ECC POS field have correct ECC byte positions at 6, 22, 38, or 54. If you bumped into issues when flashing NAND using U-boot NAND command, This may be an area you want to check. There is more information in the NAND ECC layout documents in the URL shown in the slide. Once you have confirmed that the U-boot ECC layout aligns with the RBL, then the U-boot can be updated using the NAND command from U-boot. You will erase the existing image and replace it by writing the new image. First, use TFTP to download the new U-boot binary .ais file to the OMAP-L138 LCDK. The downloaded image file is hex 78A38 bytes. The command NAND info shows that NAND page size is 2K 2048 bytes. For the NAND erase and the NAND write commands, use the file size of hex 79,000 bytes, which is aligned to the next 2048 bytes page. The command are shown as in the capture. After NAND write finishes, the update is complete. In a scenario where there are many devices that have been deployed in the field, it is not practical to go to every site, bring down each device, and perform the U-boot update using the manual methods shown previously. Rather, the ideal method is to deploy the update using a script file that runs in Linux. This can be done through the Flash Tool utility available at the URL link shown. If the kernel version is greater than 3.2, then the following line needs to be added in FlashTool.c to get it compiled. Set a path to point to the cross-compiler, then run make to build the Flash Tool utility and transfer the Flash Tool binary and the U-boot binaries to the LCDK Linux file system. From the EVM kernel console, the MTD sysfs shows MTD1 is for the U-boot. So the U-boot.ais can be flashed onto the OMAP-L138 using the following command, as shown in the capture. The update U-boot would take effect after the next power cycle or pushing the reset button. This concludes the demonstration for the restoration and updating the U-boot image on OMAP-L138. Additional information is provided here for reference. Thank you for taking the time to watch this demonstration. If you have any questions, please post them on the Texas Instruments E2E forum at e2e.ti.com.